All right, guys, this is the Atlanta Podcast. Now, if you're not familiar with what this is, you're listening to three black guys give their perspective on the city of Atlanta in a comedic and very vulgar...
Well, I mean, it's technically one black guy and two halvesies, but...
Whoa!
Very vulgar way. So, put your earbuds in.
Yeah, turn it down if you're at work.
Earmuffs.
And look at the info of this episode, because we review a local beer every episode. So you can grab a six pack of that and chill out with your boys.
Chill. Pop it open. Listen. Drink.
Whatever, nigga.
Damn.
What up, my people? It's your boy Christian with the Atlanta Podcast, and we got another special episode for you today. We have another guest on our show, and this just isn't any guest. We have Brandon Butler of ButterATL, the very famous Instagram account you all know and follow. He will be on our show to talk about what it is they do, what it is he does, and of course get into some offbeat shenanigans with your boys.
That's what keeps me young.
It just
pissed me off because I realized how young they are a lot of times. Like,
I love watching them, like, young cats running around.
So when they talk about you, it's just like, man, what?
You know, I mean, I went deep, like I said, I got a thing. You know, anybody like, you know, was born after 2010. Like, I don't, you know,
2010.
Yeah,
that's what you're coming across,
dog. In the workplace, man.
Oh yeah, y'all look digital.
Well, I mean, I'm sorry, graduated high school like 2010. Yeah. Or whatever.
Oh, okay.
Wait a minute, that would make them nine.
Yeah.
I was like, they got butter.
Do I need to be worried in the workforce?
I
need to be worried.
Get your job right now.
Yeah. I didn't see Butta daycare in here.
Butta daycare.
Oh, shit.
Money.
Yeah.
That daycare racket is for real.
I got two of these fucking things. You got kids too, right?
I got two kids.
Daycare? You paying daycare?
Both in daycare. Should like crack from.
Yeah.
I don't see how crack kids do it.
Yeah.
Real talk.
Like, because I'm sure.
That's why they leave the kids everywhere. That's why.
Bam.
It's one or the other.
Ain't nobody going to find them. Ain't nobody going to look for them in the trash can.
I used to be at my grandma. I understand that. I used to love it, but like when I used to stay with my grandma. And then, like, my cousins would get dropped off, and then they'd just be there for 4 days.
Oh, yeah.
And then my grandma would be so mad. And I was like, why are you so mad? I was just happy to get to play with my cousins and stuff. I just realized they didn't want to pay for daycare.
Oh, no.
That's the whole racket, man.
You got to feed these?
Well, you better come get these kids. I'm like, but I want Sean to stay.
You know how much pizza costs?
Shit, I remember my old job. My homie, we had a daycare at the bottom of our job. It was, like, Bright Horizons or...
I don't fucking know.
Where does yeah. Yours goes to your wife's school. But at a discount, it was a stack for a kid.
Yeah, the discount is a facade. It's bullshit.
A stack?
Per month.
Sound about right.
Yeah.
For just Monday through Friday, 8 hours a day.
And a stack for one?
Yeah.
That's too much.
You know, if the kids don't go, you still got to pay for it. Like, you got to hold their spot. So, like, if they don't go a certain day, like, you still got to pay.
Yeah,
because that's money that they could have.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
And so they get like vacation days.
I gotta have a job where my kids cool come to work with me.
Oh, good luck, because they don't exist. They're like, oh, you bringing what? Okay, we'll call you back next week.
You're on the forklift.
Yeah. I keep checking the schedule. I ain't on it. Right. Oh, you know, we had to cut back hours. Anyway. You want to start? You're all ready to start the show?
Let's start the show.
Wow, wow, wow. Chappelle Show.
Chappelle Show, man.
Better not bring your kids.
You better. That's the stack of
money. You have light skin right now.
I am?
He is.
For a change.
Tan? It's the hair.
It is. You put some juices and berries in there.
Juices and berries. Finally. Normally it's cut, clean cut. No facial hair.
Is it?
As clean as it can be.
Oh, okay, man. I got
it. Fucking Lawrenceville. Fuck you, man.
Yeah, you're right. You're
anyway.
Which one am I drink first?
Oh, yeah, you figure that out.
this again first.
You want to do the
different ones?
Two different ones.
Okay.
Might as well let the guest choose. Which one would you like to drink first?
Hell yeah.
I want to know my options. I would say, okay.
We're going to drink both of them, though. So.
Oh, yeah.
You just whichever first.
Let's start with this one.
Ta-da.
Oh, yeah.
We did a quick little quickie episode when I had this in the fridge.
That
they killed. This shit is good.
Is that like normally sold?
They might have more at the.
It's like chocolate syrup.
At the brewery. It's a gingerbread stout aged in rum barrels.
How much sugar you think is in there?
How much sugar? It's
just probably a lot. That shit tastes.
Don't think about it.
They just dump it right in the tank.
I bet that was delicious. Yeah. Shut up, man! Man, come on.
Hey, I'm trying to celebrate this month. Exactly. Shut the fuck up.
What is it? It's
Happy Pride Month.
Happy Pride Month. Keep these colors running.
I
didn't
call my brother.
Yeah, you do.
His birthday was yesterday.
Oh, his birthday? Shit. Wait, hold up.
That's my
your
ATL salute.
Brother's,
it's a pride.
Your gay brother's birthday is in Pride Month.
There's a lot of people born in June, well, not just my gay brother.
But
I mean, that's a good. Relevancy. That's accurate
for relevancy, though.
I mean, if I was gay, if there was ever a time to have a birthday, I'd assume
Pride Month,
right?
Y'all are disgusting.
I apologize.
We will get to the actual show.
All right, let's start the show.
You are now in the mix with the Atlanta Podcast.
What up, people? Welcome to the Atlanta Podcast. It's your boy Christian.
Justin.
And Martin.
And we're talking to you about stuff going on in Atlanta. We actually have a special guest on the episode today. We would like to introduce ButterATL's editor-in-chief, Brandon Butler, a.k.a. Hurricane Brandon.
That's in there? They wrote that in there? Hurricane Brandon?
I wrote it in there.
Shit.
Is that not... Should we erase that
name?
You
can take it out.
Well, are people now looking for you out there?
Well, I mean, it's not hard to find one of them.
Okay, why are you called Hurricane Brandon?
Streets?
I don't know. It just keeps popping up places. Like somebody left it on my desk the other day. Like, I came in, it was like a picture of me. It was like Hurricane Brandon was here. It kind of.
Do you fuck shit up at work?
On occasion.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Shit.
It might be a nickname no one told you about.
You know.
Are you from Miami?
No, East Side.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Stone Mountain.
Hey, a lot on you over here.
See?
Let's go.
Eastside niggas. Bonding and shit.
Clarkston.
Eastside too.
Eastside, I kind of make it.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, where you from, Justin?
Southside till I die, baby.
Eastside.
We're in the Southside.
Clayton County.
The Florida of Atlanta.
Clayton's finest. Hey, made it out, still alive, got all my fingers and toes.
Do you?
Trash.
All right.
I mean.
Before we get into it, before every episode, we like to crack open a local beer to enjoy and discuss with our jack of all drafts, Myron. So, Myron, what we got on tap?
So, what we got on tap tonight is.
Say that with attitude.
Every now and then.
You know.
What we got on tap?
It's the hair.
Mm-hmm. It's the hair.
It's bigger. It's blacker.
It's getting that long hair out of it. You look less and less Republican.
Yeah, man.
That is true.
We might get them back.
Yo, it's the new job.
It's the new job with the Italian?
You got black people at this job, right?
I'm like the only.
Oh.
I mean, there's a handful of us, but I'm like the only black straight male.
Okay.
It's very lonely.
Problem,
very lonely. Very lonely. Can we keep up enjoying this? Can we?
Yes.
It got a little dark.
Y'all got a job. No, I'm just kidding.
Tell us.
So where's this dude?
Where is it?
I work with a lot of Italians. I don't know.
But yeah, we'll be drinking on right now is a new beer from Orpheus Brewing. Shout out to Orpheus. They just had their 5-year anniversary.
Oh, they've been over 5 years.
Yeah. That's crazy to me because I've been there 5 years.
Oh, wow, yeah.
I started working there a few months before the first year anniversary.
Wow.
Still there as a hobby. The homies. Yeah. Free beer, too. Shout out.
Shout out.
It's one of the new releases. It's called You Only Live.
Oh, that's that expensive shit, ain't it?
I don't know. It looked fancy.
It's a limited release. Milkshake style IPA.
Oh, yeah. It was a milkshake one?
Yeah, so
that last one was pretty good.
For those of you who don't know, milkshake style IPAs have lactose or lactose sugar in them to give it a more creamy mouthfeel. Whatnot. Children.
I swear.
Go ahead, crack this open. Brandon started early. So.
I was about to say,
you're good.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. The offer, I was just saying.
We started drinking before. So.
Yeah, we already started. Like,
with that, you already gave it a taste.
Yeah, go ahead. Get in there.
Go ahead.
At your own will, you good.
So the color is like most IPAs. You get a golden straw-colored ale. You get the nose. A little sweet in the nose.
That shit smell like candy rain.
It does, actually.
There it is.
Do you ever dream?
Yeah, I heard they're fucked up now. It's terrible. Anyway,
well, as
they still got that hit though. And you can still get some from them.
Yeah,
let that shit play.
Add
it. Still goes off.
Those are big facts.
The Essence Fest coming up. So.
Oh, you know that shit.
You turn that shit on. It's gonna be.
Oh, it's a wrap. Yeah. It's a wrap.
In New Orleans.
Yes,
bro. It's happening.
But yeah, so anyway,
the beer.
This actually, I tasted it on draft our anniversary weekend, but I haven't tasted out the can. It's not as sweet as it was before, which is a good thing, in my opinion. It's a little sweetness on the back end.
It's too sweet.
On has draft. A little, yeah, almost right, like Justin. You know.
Damn.
We celebrating. Just go.
Damn, celebrating, man.
B. Let's go.
But you get almost gay. Like
fuck Chick-fil-A. Go ahead.
Is that, yeah. It actually tastes.
That's how we started on Popeyes.
We start with Popeyes first.
That's because you said
No. We start with Popeyes first, and then with the Chick-fil-A. Because I asked you, is it better than Chick? Oh, he asked.
This
you.
Episode might come out before that episode.
They'll put it together.
Smart. They're like, oh, I know what they're talking
about. Smart.
It don't matter.
Let's all go. Right.
That new chicken sandwich is fire.
Okay.
Anyway. So this actually tastes like, have you ever had those cotton candy grapes?
Mm-hmm.
This is actually what it tastes like.
Cotton candy. Sweet and gold.
Let me see your Tootsie Roll.
We're done with the songs. Yes. All right. Well, everybody, it's time to play Guess the Race. We normally like to kick off a conversation with a friendly game called Guess the Race. I will tell a local story involving a crime, and you, along with Justin, Myron, and Brandon, can guess the race of the culprit. All right, here we go. A man accused of opening fire on two electrical contractors as they left his home in March was indicted last week on a host of charges. The 69-year-old man was indicted by a grand jury last Thursday on charges of malice murder, felony murder, two counts of aggravated assault, and two counts of possession of a firearm during the commission of a felony, court records show. The culprit is accused of shooting 21-year-old Jake Horn and his boss, Gordon Montcalm, as they left his home on March 6th after a day's work. Horn was shot in the head and later died.
Damn.
Montcalm, who was shot in the face, neck, and arm.
Shit.
Stop.
I already know this is about money. I already know this is about money.
It might be.
Damn.
Face, neck, and arm survived his injuries, police said.
Oh, shit. Oh.
It's unclear what led to the shooting, but detectives testified that part of the incident was captured on the shooter's doorbell camera.
So he saw.
At a hearing in March, the police said the shooter could be heard in the video repeatedly telling Montcalm, "You killed my pets," before shooting the electrician several times.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
I had an idea, but now I know.
Yeah, right.
Damn.
No one's half the battle.
Detective Phil Stoddard testified there was no evidence any pets were harmed. The shooter's defense asked the court to order a mental evaluation. The shooter appeared before a judge last Tuesday for a probable cause hearing.
He is now waiting for grand jury to consider charges of murder, aggravated assault, and aggravated battery. Guess the race of the shooter.
White.
Yeah.
Damn. Damn.
That's white.
Yeah.
Why?
First of all, who loves their pets like that?
I mean,
can we kill somebody over some pets? Fire. Come on now.
The Ring doorbell gave it away.
Yeah.
Yes. That's
the
video
doorbell. The Ring doorbell gave it away. I mean, that instantly gave it away. Have you used the Ring doorbell?
I don't have one. You don't have one, and you got kids.
Let me tell you. I got dogs too.
But he's also in Lawrenceville. Well, your dogs are bitches.
Let me tell you, I recently got a Ring doorbell. You got one? And so it has this, besides the Ring, it has this app on there called like Neighborhoods, where like other people who have Rings, they like put their videos and stuff up, like, oh, look at these people that pulled in my driveway. Has anybody seen them? I'm just telling you, like, anytime I hear a story in a part of his, and so through his Ring. Right. All right, so we're talking like, and he's 69? Okay, middle class. Ring doorbell.
But I heard 69 and what 69-year-old exercises their Second Amendment rights?
And then guns.
Other than motherfucking white men.
And then guns.
I was just like,
like, I can pull up the app right now on my phone and show you people that are sitting there watching it. Like, who's this coming to my door with a Georgia Power truck? Look at this. Like, it's Georgia Power lady.
Right? Oh,
so
shit.
The Ring doorbell and the combination of
but you have Second a Ring doorbell.
Firearms.
Right. You like guns.
Yes, that's a fact.
We're three different people. We're different people. Though.
But combined, y'all don't become one white person.
That's true.
Wait a minute. Those two things combined with the ridiculous love of pets.
Yeah.
Oh.
And 69.
Do you want to know his name?
Sure. Let's just see.
Hold on. I got this shit.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all about to, we must be wrong. About to blow y'all fucking mind.
Wait, oh wait, did you say weird this was?
Who no, I didn't. Counts?
Oh,
intentionally.
That would okay. That would have been a good clue.
He didn't say weird.
His first name is Larry.
Okay.
Good answer.
You want to know where?
go.
Still sticking with white?
I'm sticking with it. Fuck you.
You want to know where the house is?
Yes.
East Cobb.
We're good.
You also gotta have Wi-Fi to have Ring too. So I'm just saying, gotta have Wi-Fi.
Deeper,
the details.
Deeper.
The devil's in the details.
Don't be trying to get us to switch. Let's go.
I ain't talking about like a cell phone hotspot.
Nah, bro.
Dedicated Wi-Fi.
I do got that on my mind.
Oh, wait a minute. Whoa. And he was having the contractors come to his house. You know black people steal cable. Shit. Come on now.
It wasn't his cousins either. It was like.
You're right. Exactly.
Yeah.
His last name is Epstein.
Boom.
Yes.
That.
Yes.
He's black.
Can't be.
I'm lies. Just kidding. No, he's white. He's lies. White. You guys won. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Yeah, that's two in a row.
Racism
in a row.
Is real.
Two in a row. We had like a slide. He started hitting
we did.
Weird when it's like Asians.
Well, like, I mean, y'all know y'all's, y'all know y'all's white people, I guess.
You gotta know the enemy.
Jeez.
Hey,
we
man.
We got some allies?
Don't act like you never laid down with the reparations.
No, they just had the Netflix just released the miniseries on the Five.
The Five?
Central Park Five. I haven't watched it yet. You watched it?
I'm just mad.
You watched it?
Hella mad.
Yeah.
I can't even.
It's like the new Roots.
I gotta be in the mood. New Roots. You watched it?
No, how many Roots?
No,
I'm gonna watch it. I was like, I gotta be in the mood for it.
I feel like we got 18 new Roots.
I'm talking about like Roots.
Oh,
I'm talking about like standard definition Roots.
Damn.
VHS.
The one of you to come in on 17 part series.
Shout out to
TBS. It's a mini series.
Yeah, it's a mini series.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like they go all the way back.
Oh, okay.
Like I'd always get a little tense when Roots, because it'd be on for like 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Like the NBA playoffs.
Y'all remember they did a new Roots
right when February hits.
Exactly.
There was a Roots with T.I. in it when they did like.
Stop.
That was ATL.
Oh.
What you
talking about? Yeah. It was another.
No, that
Roots.
Was recently. That
yeah,
was a
it
new
too
Roots.
Long ago, like,
it was just like a remade Roots.
Like a movie?
A miniseries.
Okay.
I never watched it though, because I think they only like showed it once.
So one time T.I. couldn't use those big ass words because they'd be like, nigga, you know how to read. Who taught you?
They're cut his feet off immediately. Fuck that shit.
He be confusing the masses. They be like, wait, what?
He said, no, not my fibula. What the fuck?
We gotta run to the north expeditiously.
Time travel.
Shout out to T.I.
T.I. All right. Now, on to our guest.
Let's go.
Brandon. Now, if you can you tell us what Butta is?
Yeah, man. Butta is a media company, you know what I mean? Founded here in Atlanta, you know, focused on Atlanta culture. You know what I'm saying? So, in the simplest way to put it, people always say Atlanta doesn't get a chance to tell its own stories, have people, you know what I mean, talking about, you know, the content, the things that are going on in the city by people in and around the city, made by people that are kind of from here and they get it. So we just kind of started putting together a team to just start making shit and telling stories about Atlanta, you know what I mean, and kind of seeing where it all took us, you know. So if you think about, you know, AJC, Creative Loafing, you know, all those different outlets, you know what I mean? Just really even thinking about it more through the context of, like, what would it be like today when everybody's got a cell phone, when everybody's on, you know, social media, and that's where they consume a lot of that information first, right? So,
yeah,
you know, the world has kind of evolved past a lot of those same old print. But again, everybody says cell phone, but again, like, the way that people consume content through Instagram is different than Facebook, which is different than the web in general. So, you know, Butta is just, you know, trying to just put content in new places, or in places for people. Really kind of said founded by Atlanta. So think about Complex, think about, you know, Vice, think about, you know, BuzzFeed, all those kind of things. If you kind of put all those up in a blender, in a sense, and kind of had it within Atlanta root, you know, that's what we're kind of trying to create. You know what I mean? Something that really just tells those stories, but also does it, you know, in a real kind of way. You know what I mean? So we touch on all different sides of the city. You know, it's not just, you know, everybody hollers the Beltline and gentrification. You know what I mean? We're not just here to, like, tell the pretty parts. We talk about other stuff. We create all kinds of content. We make it for all kinds of people. So, yeah, man, we're just making stuff, telling stories.
So, oh, so is this from the perspective, or from a certain perspective, as in, like, maybe, you know, black ATLians, or just young ATLians, or just, it doesn't matter, ATL, from various perspectives, from various backgrounds, things of that nature?
Yeah, man.
Do you have Larry Epstein's perspective?
I mean, look.
You know, have his voice being told.
69-year-old East Cobb murderers aren't really our demographic. You know
that's
what I'm
fair.
Saying?
That's fair. Okay.
You
that's
know,
fair.
You gotta pick your, you gotta pick your shots. You know what I'm saying? But oh man, that's right. Oh,
oh, oh shit!
Oh, no pun intended.
No pun intended.
Right?
shout out to those families.
But no, nah, man, you know,
it's real.
Shout out to the family. Bro.
They need it.
Condolences.
Yeah, condolences. Okay,
that's what I meant. It's the same thing.
A shout out, condolences, the same thing?
And shout out is too much like shout out.
Okay.
Oh, see, condolences. I wouldn't go that far.
Condolences to those families. Fuck Larry Epstein. We're not about that life.
Larry was about that life, clearly.
That ring
life. Tool on deck.
And his fucking pets were alive. Anyway, go ahead.
Sorry.
All kind of folks, right? I mean, I think a simple way to kind of look at it is, I always say there's, like, old Atlanta, there's new Atlanta, and then there's, like, everybody that only has heard about Atlanta really through it, new Atlanta, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's really what I think Atlanta really does at a national level, because we create so much content here, so much culture
that
drives, you know, national culture, but, like, everybody doesn't necessarily know all the nitty-gritty in the city, right? So I always kind of say, like, old Atlanta is if you kind of grew up out here like I did, you know, through the Olympics, you know, kind of into, like, the late 2000s, you know what I mean, like 2008 9 10, you know, or if you graduated high school like 2008 9 10 on, I kind of call that new Atlanta, right? I kind of call those people that were here again, but, like, you know, 8 9 10 and back, you know what I mean, through the Olympics, all that kind of stuff, like old Atlanta. Because I know, again, for me, I've seen the city, you know what I mean, transform over the years. I grew up in Stone Mountain.
It's gotten brighter. It's gotten very brighter.
It's gotten a lot different. It's gotten a lot different, you know, certain areas you used to go into. You know, now you're hanging out, walking around,
Whole Foods.
You know, craft beer.
When you see the strollers coming out, you know, when you see those little three-wheel strollers, you know.
They jogging, jog strollers.
Yeah, the jog strollers. You know what I'm saying?
Hashtag Monday Night Garage.
Yeah, man. So, you know, so we make it, I think for us, you know what I mean, we try to definitely skew a little bit, you know, newer, younger. I think that what Atlanta really drives is, like, what's kind of current here, like, in the last 6 months. But you also got to give recognition to, like, the shit that built the foundation. You know what right. I mean? So, like, we still got, you know, Outkast is my favorite group. We still got Mad Love for, like, everything that helped set up Atlanta to where it was. But we can't just sit here and talk about the good old days, right? A lot of that stuff is gone. You know what I mean? And it was great while it was here. But, you know, there's a lot of good stuff about Atlanta now, too. You know what I mean? So we try to keep that balance.
Yeah, as the saying goes, you can't know where you're going if you don't know where you came from.
Yeah, like,
Mm-hmm.
Appreciate like the past and everything, but then also be moving forward.
His was mm-hmm. better.
Yeah, you know.
But I appreciate it.
Brandon had a soundbite, Nitty Gritty in the City. I like that.
Oh yeah, I'm cutting that.
Right.
Swagger Jack.
That's dope. And you said you've been around, like, you started in 2017.
Yeah, we launched Butter, and I was what year is it? 2019 now. So yep.
Time's getting fucking
mid 2018. I think we kind of really got it cranking. Okay. So it's been almost a year. Okay. You know, we've been like fully humping along.
What would you say? How do you think the old Atlanta and the new Atlanta, like how they view the city, or like?
You know, it's funny because I mean I get a lot of it's interesting. Like I wasn't really deep in this social media world like I am now, so I get a lot of stuff that's just hilarious, like a lot of DMs and comments and stuff, and I just think,
oh wait a minute, what's the craziest DM you've gotten?
I'm scared to hear that.
Oh man, I mean off the top of my head, I mean, well, just as it relates to like the Butter, you know, I mean everything from threats of clout demons coming to get us if we don't.
Clout demons? It's like Super Mario?
What the fuck is a clout demon?
I don't know. That's the one that always sticks out to me. It was like, I'm thinking it was like, if you don't do something, we're going to unleash clout demons on you or something. I was like, clout demons?
I'm hearing that Mario, like, Haunted Mansion song right now.
The one where he's coming in. Yeah, he's turning around. He's just like, look at him.
Clout demons.
Cloud Demon since NES.
Yeah. Cloud Demon.
You know, so we see some interesting stuff. You know, some interesting things come through the DMs and the emails sometimes.
Anything positive?
Yeah. We get lots of love too. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, we get lots of love, but I think
because your followers are just like ridiculous right now, right?
Hey, that's what's
up. We're doing all right.
That's all right. Shit, we doing terrible.
What shows this game?
We're up and coming.
Yeah. Grassroots, whatever that means.
But yeah, I think you said like, so like, how do they deal view each other? I think it's interesting just because, like, again, people tend to holler like gentrification. I mean, that's the funny part. I literally get emails, texts, it's like gentrification. It's like, what? What is gentrification? What is being gentrified?
Oh, like they just like attack just Butter. Attack. Just like,
you know what I mean?
Not knowing, like, who's behind the scenes.
Yeah, I mean, I think anything, again, like that's perceived to have some level of whiteness associated with it sometimes just gets just weird. Like,
so okay, a lot of people have been in Atlanta for.
Well, I tell you, believe it. There are white people in Atlanta. Yeah. You know what I mean? And like, just because. And again, like, you know, I went to Morehouse, right? Well, I went to Morehouse for my. I didn't graduate from Morehouse, but I did go to Morehouse back when the West End was the West End.
Better than me.
And I'm just telling you, like, it's a lot better now that you can walk from Morehouse and Spelman to the mall without having to worry about walking through the hood. You know what I'm saying? Like, but then you get people who are like, oh, that's gentrification. And like, yeah, but it's cool.
It's safety.
Because I'm not getting robbed anymore, right? Like,
there's a reason those gates were around Spelman. That's what was there for.
There was this gas station I used to see out my dorm, man. I think it was on Lee Street. I saw people get robbed, shot at over there all the time, like when I was in school. And I was thinking to myself, like, fuck this shit.
Yeah. Fuck these grades.
I took my ass to Georgia Southern. I love it.
That's right. You're from Georgia Southern. You say that is the
real GSU.
Oh, stop it. Okay. We're done with this show now.
I never went to any of those.
The thievery around West End was all the way live. Like my cousin, he went to Morehouse way back when too. And sometimes I would like sneak out and then like. My cousin's from South Carolina, so he came here to school. Okay. So I was like, oh, hang out with my old cousin. My mom was like, at Morehouse? Hell no. Whatever. I was like, no, it's during the day. She was like, at Morehouse? Hell no.
West End used to be live back in the day, man.
My cousin went, but we went back to the dorm room. He was going up the stairs, and he saw former homie coming out his room with his shoes on. Not like stealing them in his hand. He put them shits on. And he's like, nigga, that... dude ran down, looked in the dorm room. He left his old shoes there in the box. Hold on. He had just brought some J's. Yeah. The dude switched the shits out. Yeah. I was like, nigga, what? This is like a restaurant. Stay fresh.
Like butter.
Whole game.
That shit was crazy.
Like I said, man, you know, little change doesn't hurt. You know, like, right. I used to go to church off of Glenwood growing up at Piney Grove. And I remember we used to, like, pick up these kids from East Lake Meadows back in the day. If you remember East Lake Meadows, Little Vietnam, they used to call it, right? Mm-hmm. Like, before they went and tore all that stuff down, man, like, we used to go through there and pick up. It was this this group they would call the Cool Girls. And we would pick them up, and they would do, like, tutoring back at our church. And we would go get them. And we used to have a police escort with the church van.
Y'all got the Asians to tutor? Y'all got Vietnamese women to tutor?
No, they wasn't Vietnamese.
Oh!
They called it Little Vietnam because it was... Because it was Little Vietnam over there. Because it was...
Oh. Yeah.
So East Lake Meadows, like, back off of Glenwood.
Trigger fingers.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Like, East Lake Chirac.
They're not talking about because of the food.
No. I was like, that's actually pretty smart. No.
Bro, you'd roll through there at night. So we'd have to roll through there at night in a church van with the police escort because they'd rob the church van.
Oh,
so, I mean, so you know what? It's good that some shit isn't here anymore. You know what I mean? Now, I understand.
Now, look, the fucked up thing is they all moved to Clayton County.
Right. Now, that's the part of it. They moved them all to Clayton.
Why is it getting so bad? Out of here, guys.
And that may not happen. People got displaced. But I'm just saying, like, the things around the city had to kind of change. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, like, hopefully as things change, you got people in there now paying attention. Because I think the thing now is just stuff is getting so expensive. Mm-hmm. That's the dangerous part. You know what I mean? And, like, a lot of people don't realize it because especially nowadays, you know, everybody's about, like, this Uber life, this, like, on-demand stuff. And what they don't realize is, like, all this land, everything is getting snatched up.
Yep.
So, you know, you need to pay attention to that.
That's the true mark of gentrification.
Right.
Is displacing the people, raising it up, and then, you know, allowing them to come back, but knowing that they can't afford it.
Yeah. So be like Jay said, man, gentrify your own neighborhoods. You know what I'm saying? That's, like, go buy back your own stuff. You know what I'm saying?
That's true. For me, it kind of, I get a little angsty when thinking about the hardships that, like, what is the old Atlanta people had to go through.
Yeah.
And the hardships that the new Atlanta people have to go through, which is what, like, crazy Uber rides? I don't know. Like,
Uber rides are crazy, though. Like, some of them are wild.
And I don't know, like, I just... What? I wish there was, I wish there was, like, a way to validate how Atlanta you are by what you've experienced in Atlanta.
But why does it matter though? I think it's all. I mean, it's all relative based on the day and age.
Like levels, like thetans, like Scientology. How clear are you? How ATL are
you? You ever seen the ATL tattoo? Like, there's an official ATL tattoo. That you can only, like, it's like the honor system basically, but it's like ATL, and you can go get it from, like, a couple of different tattoo artists out here, and it's like the honor system. Like, if you straight up ATL. You can go get one. That's
do
like
you
your.
How do you need, like,
what is no, your birth certificate? It's all
I'm
in the honor system.
I was about to say, I'm a Grady baby.
It's all in the honor system.
I was born in Chicago.
Do you need. So if you. Can somebody G check your ATL tattoo?
I guess so. I don't know.
Can you get into exclusive places with this?
I mean, look, man. If you know, you know. You know what I'm saying?
Damn, I don't know.
We don't know, bro.
Don't worry about it.
We got to change the name of this podcast.
No.
You can definitely get one of you. Yeah, you got one.
Hell yeah.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Dope. So,
I got to see this tattoo.
Right? What does it look like?
You got to know.
Oh, hey, whoa, too much information.
You know.
This nigga lives in Lawrenceville from Chicago. Nah, bro. This ain't for you. This ain't for you.
It's just property is just so much more affordable. I got kids and shit, man.
You sound like them, too.
There ain't that many more yards in Atlanta.
You sound like them, too.
That's why I'm upset, because these rich white kids. No, I'm just kidding. I love white people.
Wait, me from Chicago?
I was born in Chicago. Well, the area that I was born in.
This is the drill music? Maywood?
No, I was only there for 1 year.
New Chicago. No, that's New Chicago.
Up here, though.
I was only there for 1 year, and then we had to bounce. The story of that, that's a whole other story. But
y'all came to a terrible neighborhood in Atlanta.
It was better.
Hey, you made it.
Hey, that's my Touchdown. Wife's parents. Both of her parents from Chicago, and they moved to the hood here, and they were like, "This is great." Like, real talk.
Sunshine. We left East St. Louis to get to go to beautiful Army bases, and it was just that was heaven.
Hmm. But you Army brat though, so
yeah, it was great. We had like shops and.
And you, were you born here?
I was born in L.A. and moved out here when I was 6 months old.
Oh, you definitely so yeah.
And from the East Side too.
Straight to the East Side.
All the way to the East Side.
Respect.
Dope. So what kind of projects are y'all getting into now with Butta? Like, what's going before?
Before we get into that, you know, I feel like we're still thirsty. I'm still thirsty. So we can get to another beer. Mm. This is another beer from that was released from Orpheus on their anniversary. It's nice. This Again. And it's a
wait, the same beer?
No, it's called This Again.
Oh!
It's a riff on a series of pineapple sours. The first one was Over and Over, then Over and Over and Over, and then Over and Over and Over again.
I'm hard on fruity beers.
And then now is This Again. Oh. So this one is
I see what you did there.
Right. So this is a pineapple sour with guava and vanilla.
Mm.
Okay.
This is actually one of my faves out of the series.
Is guava a fruit?
It is.
We or had a vegetable.
It's a fruit.
It's a fruit.
This on a previous episode, this man had never had a fresh. Was it a peach?
That's true.
Yeah, mm-hmm. He was just like
cobbler, but I never had like a whole peach.
Like the fruit. Just
eat fruit at all.
Like. I had a tangerine though. I had a tangerine before.
Like a fruit roll.
Like a cutie. Right.
Like an actual. Did you actually peel it? Like.
No, I'm just
he was like skin. What the hell is that? Rind? No, it comes up rolled. I unrolled it.
I had to go get one. Please. And they're delicious.
Well, yeah. we're glad you're.
I didn't have one.
I mean,
food deserts. We talked about under the podcast.
That is another food episode. I was fruit in desert. Food deserts. That is true. Yeah, I mean, it was three. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. So yeah, the color is light straw color. It has has a thick head on it.
Yeah, it does.
Hey. I know y'all want to say that sort of shit. God.
It's Pride Month, baby.
What the hell does that have to do with anything?
Well, yeah, shout out to my big bro.
Damn.
I know you out there on the road doing your thing.
Anyway.
Doing your thing.
Is he a truck driver?
Oh, no.
He's going to come with the show and kick our ass.
He probably will.
He really is. His brother's swollen shit. It's not even a joke.
Yeah.
But, yeah, if you get the nose, you actually get a lot of guava in it.
Oh, yeah?
You get the pineapple, get the guava, and then the vanilla kind of rounds out the flavor. Uh-huh. Gives a little smoothness to it.
Dope.
This is a great spring-summer beer. I mean,
ooh, it tastes summery.
Atlanta doesn't have spring, so it's just summer. It's hot as fuck. Already.
Yeah, what's going on with that?
Already.
I love it.
Yeah?
I love it.
You like sweaty backs?
Yes.
Wait a minute.
Not on niggas! Shout out to Pride Month, though.
We didn't say that.
But no.
We didn't say that. Hey, man. Hey.
Look, we hear the other podcast.
Different strokes for different folks.
Hey.
Hey, that's you all do. You.
You that do.
Is all nah, I just you. Don't mind the heat.
Let them colors me. Fly, homie.
But anyway, so
let's,
yeah.
Let's get to a commercial break real quick, and then we'll get back to the episode.
This man's hitting out on backs.
Jesus.
I finally did it. Popeye's new chicken sandwich.
Mm.
I've been trying to make the perfect chicken sandwich forever.
How does that make you feel?
You know me. It had to be just right. Mm-hmm. Finding a bun as good as my chicken was not easy. Mm. I mean, I did it, obviously.
I think we've made a lot of progress here. I feel great. Good talk. I'm proud of you.
My new chicken sandwich is buttermilk battered and served on toasted brioche. Try it in spicy or classic.
Love that chicken from Popeyes.
Now we're back to the episode. Now back to what we were saying. What does Butta have churning right now? What's going on?
Hey.
Let's see if you can do it.
Every now and then. I think I picked it up from an article that y'all already wrote.
So. Swagger
Jack. Yeah, it was a swagger. Swagger Jack.
You know, just start off this year just saying like more and better.
More and better.
We're just looking for, more types of content, really along the lines of like shows. I think franchise kind of pieces of content, shows like so Atlantipedia. is one of the things kind of a lot of people saw that we've kind of went through into the whole first season of that. You know, the A from A to Z is what we kind of called it.
Ooh,
nice. So we had, you know, different folks, influencers, celebrities and folks coming through and basically doing different letters of the alphabet, talking about the ATL. Did another series called Sneak Her Heads with Watch Blossom out here. Basically, it's about female shoe collectors out here in the city.
Oh,
so it was like a 4-part series that we did.
That's actually a good one because, you know, when you see sneakerheads out here, I've rarely or ever just see female sneakerheads.
I don't think I've ever had met a female sneakerhead.
You always see the dudes just like, you know, camping out. You know, they got the two closets full of, you know, the fresh shit they ain't even wear yet, you know, but you rarely see, you know, female sneakerheads.
Yeah.
You always see female shoes, you know, shoe heads like, you know, stilettos and all that shit.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. Not sneakers. So
those pumps in the club.
Yep. Yeah, yep. Yeah.
Yeah, and we got another series with a DJ Screen that we do. Basically, it's called Whipped, and they basically just rolled around with different cars in Atlanta, talking about cars and history and different celebrity interviews and stuff like that. So
it's fucking dope.
You know, like just more stuff like that. So we're in the process right now, kind of like building out and expanding our studio, looking to build a podcast studio out. So that'll be coming soon.
Nice.
Working with some ATL podcasts and kind of hopefully building like a little podcast network and
like the ATL podcast.
Hey, you know, I don't want to put it on tape or anything right now.
No,
you know,
no.
I don't want to, but you know, we'll see what happens.
Mm-hmm.
Oh shit!
I met one girl who was a sneakerhead, but all she did was wear Vans.
Is that a sneakerhead?
I don't know if that does that count.
She's just wearing something convenient and
she was all about just Vans, though. She was like a West Coast chick.
Oh, if that's the case, yes, that's West Coast sneakerhead.
Vans
sure.
Make her dance.
She did take Vans.
There you go.
She was dancing, though.
That sounds like a Weird Al Yankovic parody.
Hey,
to make her
right.
Weird Al, holler at us because you'll never fucking listen to this.
You never know.
No,
he's sitting in the studio right now.
We got people in Japan. We got people in Japan.
So, where can this content be found? Like these videos, is it just on Instagram or can this YouTube or?
Yeah, so we launched primarily on IG right now.
Okay.
We're pushing more stuff on the IGTV, and then we're in the early stages of standing up kind of some more content for YouTube. So that's where you're gonna start seeing a lot more stuff for us probably over the next like 2-3 months.
Oh, wow.
Once we kind of get everything built out as YouTube, more long-form stuff, continue to do stuff on IG.
Yeah.
A little bit of stuff will probably go, like, on Facebook, too. But YouTube and IG are going to probably be the main platforms.
Mm. Fuck
what's the YouTube page?
It's just Butter Atlanta.
Yeah, probably the title of the fucking...
Just making sure so everybody hears it.
That's, you know what? That's fair.
I'm still getting used to it. Yeah, whatever. Like, follow, subscribe.
Yeah,
we gotta say it.
Smash that button.
You gotta say.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Below
awesome.
In the link in this video. Yeah. So you said you your family, obviously you didn't have a choice. Your family moved out here. What about Atlanta drew your family to it?
That was back in, you know, back in the 80s. I think, you know, back then Atlanta. Really is what it is now, man. I think it's an opportunity, kind of a mecca for people of color. You
it's
know,
like
that's what my dad was like. It was chocolate city. We gotta go.
You know what I mean? Like
Jada Pinkett and Kanye was gonna move to Atlanta.
Like my dad's side, we were from like Watts, like 113th and Central. I got a lot of cousins over there that like to wear certain colors and things like that.
Shit.
So, you know, I'm one of the few on the men on my side of the family that kind of didn't end up in all that, so I think that was probably a big part of it, just kind of wanting to see something different.
Mm-hmm.
And again, like Atlanta, again, has always been that place, man. Like I say, when you travel, you notice, like, when you get off the plane in other cities, like, you don't see an abundance of people of color like you do when you land in Atlanta.
Very true.
You know what I mean? So I think just it was then what it is now, which is just a place where people can come and kind of, like, start their life and kind of see an opportunity here, and that's probably that's what brought them out here and, you know.
So, with that being said, how do you feel about the rapid growth of Atlanta? As you see, you know, the traffic has gotten ridiculous. Everybody wants to start their life in Atlanta now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, how do you feel about that?
You know, I mean, the growth is the growth, right? I think the funny thing about Atlanta, it's a lot of funny things about it, but I always say, like, they burned the city down 2 times and fucked it up both times, and they rebuilt it because they never put it on the grid. You know, it's like, this is putting more peace trees over here. So, you know, and then so you see stuff like that. You see stuff like the mass transit and, like, you know, MARTA and access to stuff like that, and you kind of get annoyed with it, I think. You know, for folks who are around here, you kind of know how the city ebbs and flows. So while it's not the best... I don't really sweat it. You know what I mean? It's like, you know what? I know what time to leave the house. I know what time to stay home.
Yeah.
I know when traffic starts. I think, if anything, the thing that gets on my nerves about it is like when you get, Atlanta's a very transient city, right? Like, definitely. So a lot of people who live here aren't from here. And big so facts, it's interesting, facts. Like when you watch things like Atlanta United versus like the Shut Hawks up. And the Falcons, right? In other words, people came to Atlanta with affiliations with like basketball and football teams.
Yeah. Yep.
So the Knicks come, play the Hawks. It's gonna be a million. It's gonna be more Knicks fans in there.
Yeah.
Lakers Hell comes, yeah. gonna be more Lakers fans in there. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But Atlanta United was like one of the first things that like everybody, no matter where you were from, you got to all get Atlanta about, right? So, you know, I think like it. I hope to see more things like that. Even mm-hmm. while there are more people come out here, I want to see like more things that happen in the city that people can kind of like rally around,
right?
Yeah. And not just. You know, people come out here and they like shit on Atlanta, but it's like, well, you came out here for a reason, motherfucker.
I feel you on that. You came out here
for a reason. Why are you hating on me? You know what I'm saying?
I feel you. Like, Atlanta as a city, Atlanta as a culture, Atlanta as a sports city, I feel like it's one of those places that people love to hate.
Yeah.
It's like they you know, they shit on Atlanta all the time, but I was like, Atlanta stays in their mouth. I was like, why you keep talking? Like, if you don't like us, that's cool. Move somewhere else, talk about something else. But everybody always finds a way to put a jab in Atlanta. I'm just like, but why? Why the hate? It pisses me off so much. Me being from Atlanta, and then especially with sports, big sports fans, ATL, everything. Braves, Hawks, Falcons, United, you know, Thrashers when we had them.
Yeah.
You know.
You went to Thrashers game?
Yeah, my uncle got them.
Shout out to Georgia Storm.
Georgia fucking Storm, hey. Championships. Mm-hmm.
Georgia Swarm.
Swarm.
That's what I meant to say.
Lacrosse, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was like, who is the they Storm? Won.
No, we got a championship.
Atlanta Dream. Atlanta Dream. The WNBA team. But yeah, it pisses me. I get in so many debates. I mean, sports debates in general are fun. So it is fun and lighthearted, but it still, you know, irritates me. And then with what you pointed out.
This nigga's on a tangent.
What you pointed out. Hey, man. Hey, stop it, bro. That struck a nerve, man. That shit pisses me off. People talk shit about my Falcons, man. Pisses me off.
Bro, I was in Houston for the game, man.
Me too. Bro, I drove. I left work and hit the road.
Drove.
I was in there.
Immediately.
I used to work for Sports Radio 790 The Zone. So hey, I was the head of I was the head of digital there for like 5 years, back in the days of the Stews.
Mm-hmm.
We were the flagship for the Hawks, Braves, Falcons. Thrashers. I've seen a lot of stuff. And again, you in sports talk, you know what I'm saying? Like, you dealing with it from a whole other angle.
Right.
So I get it, bro.
And so it kind of does bug me that a lot of people, it's like a two-edged
sequel
sword.
Sequel to the tangent.
You know. I like that people latched on to Atlanta United, you know, no matter where you're from. It's like, okay, yeah, we're going to get behind it 100%. It was cool. But then I don't like it is because we had success out the gate. We had a great team.
It was
from
ridiculous
jump.
How
successful. And now folks are like, oh, yeah, I'm an ATL United fan. I was like, you're not even from here. You want to talk shit about the Braves and the Falcons, but then you're going to turn around and be like, ATL United. Make it.
Well, anyway. It's kind of like it's the trendy here. Thing now to be. Yeah.
And you gotta have a scarf. You know how I feel about trendy
gotta
shit.
Have a scarf.
Gotta have a scarf, B.
Well, you know, no matter how hot it is.
Gotta have a scarf.
The thing that helps all that is winning, though. I mean, that's what it really. Again, that's the thing that helps everything when it comes to sports, man. And that's why, you know, I hope even with what is it, the 8-10 with the Hawks, right? Like, I just hope they get some pieces in place. Like, that's why everybody wanted Zion, right? Because, like, you just need a moment where everything kind of just shifts.
Right.
You need that moment, right? Like, we've had that kind of – so we had it with Atlanta United. We got a taste of it. You know, like, the Falcons, we had a run. We should have pulled it out. But I'm just saying, you know how that's going to go. When right. Like, every Falcons game,
you know how that's gonna
third, fourth quarter, we all sitting there watching like, all right.
Exactly.
Look, okay.
Everybody's
what's going to happen?
That first half, we always killing it.
The first half.
All of a sudden, 2 minutes left in the game. Okay, they scored 20 points. We just got to stop
Can we just play two-quarter games? Why can't we just do
that? We need a new league.
That's safer, too. It's all about safety right now,
yeah,
right?
Safety first.
You see Goodell just talk about shortening the preseason.
Yeah.
You know, so I hope they get that change out there, too, man. Because, again, like, we got a lot of stuff going on. Yeah, people shit on Atlanta, but again, I think they just look at it like say the city they love to hate. Like, they don't have anything else bad to say about it. Like,
exactly,
the price of living is low. It's compared, a cool place to be compared to be a lot of places.
Hella jobs.
And again, if you don't like it, take your ass back up.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Yikes. Where you came from. Like, it's cool. Like, I could use less people on 285.
Yeah. Oh, 285. Oh. Anyway. We're reaching the end of the episode. And at the end of every episode, we like to give a special shout out called an ATL salute to someone in the ATL or Metro ATL area that has been doing something great and representing Atlanta in a big way. When we have a guest on, we hand over that responsibility to them. So, Brandon, is there anybody you would like to give an ATL salute to?
I'm going to give an ATL salute to my boy Jordan Gibbs of Milk and Cookies. They're doing big things, you know what I'm saying? I've been working with him and the team. They got some like really interesting stuff coming up from Milk and Cookies. And again, like, they just, I think, really signify like one of those movements that like really associates more like with New Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, you go to their events, you go to the Milk and Cookies Festival, you see the kind of artists, the people they bring out. They're bringing out the talent, the folks that are going to be popping, you know, in the next couple of years. And they're just really, like, in tune with what's going on right now. And I think that's, like, so significant of, like, what Atlanta is now, right? Yeah. Like, it's just people all different races, colors, backgrounds, and coming around music, hip-hop, rap, you know, and just enjoying it. And so, you know, that's why I just love all the stuff they're doing. So I'm going to give a shout-out to Jordan and the whole crew over there at Milk and Cookies.
That's awesome. Dope. I heard about that. I was just checking them out. Is this on IG?
Yeah.
Milk and Cookies Fest? Right here. It says it's like blending various music genres, tasty food selection, and creative activities to curate a blissful experience.
When is that festival?
Taste the Music. That was just the IG.
Oh, handle. Okay. You got tickets or?
I can find some tickets.
Oh, shit!
I can find some tickets.
All right. Well, thank you for being on the podcast. We appreciate it. Yeah, man. It was a great talk. And hope to see you again. All right, everybody. Peace. Deuces.
3 hours later.
Stop it.
What was that?
That was the thing.
That's
the first thing you thought about.
So you were saying you've done a podcast before?
Yeah, I've done a couple podcasts.
And what was the title again?
The most recent one I had, it was called the Dark Zuckerberg Podcast.
What was the premise
of
that?
Dope name.
That was a fantastic name.
It's my nickname, you know. So that's one of my nicknames.
Wait.
Hey.
So Dark Zuckerberg is your nickname?
You got to start worrying when somebody has a lot of AKAs.
That's way better than
the Hurricane. Now I question your motives.
I'll be honest with you. I'm scared right now.
Deep in these streets.
So I know who to.
I heard about you, Eastside niggas.
I know whose name to drop when I get my ATL tattoo, though. Hey, that's what I know.
No, don't use Dark Zuckerberg. You gotta use B twice for that one.
Oh,
B twice.
Let's go.
Yeah, that's Eastside.
Oh, I feel you.
This motherfucker got
aliases. Rename.
You want to rename? My folks live off of Phillips.
Yeah,
rename. Right there,
Hidden Hills.
Yep.
My uncle live in Hidden Hills. High School.
Southside.
Clarkston High School. Nobody. Cool.
Nah.
Yeah, nah.
Panthersville.
Nah.
I used to teach at Georgia Perimeter back in the day.
Oh, yeah?
Over right next to Clarkston.
Yeah.
Continuing education. Big old rock y'all got out there.
Yeah.
That's all I know.
Well, you got like a rock? That's like.
I mean, on the front of the school, there was a giant rock.
Southside niggas don't know shit, you know?
Yeah.
They just threw rocks.
Yeah.
It's outside.
Look, we were just out there trying to make it.
So what was the premise of the podcast?
So I had a like I said, I used to work in a sports radio. At one point in my life, I actually wanted to be on radio. So I actually my undergrad degree is in IT, computer science. I had a minor in Japanese. I only remember it after like 5 or 6 drinks.
Konnichiwa.
Oh, wow.
Konnichiwa, that's me, right? and so after I got out of school, I wanted to get like in radio. I didn't know what I was going to do. I ended up I was doing IT. I ended up deciding to move to LA for about 6 months to a year.
Went back home.
I went to DJ school.
It's a DJ school?
It's LA. Called Scratch Academy.
Tell me about this when I was a kid.
So it was founded by a Jam Master Jay before he died. There's like there's one in New York, there's one in Miami, there's one in LA.
Yeah, dude.
There's maybe a couple more because I went to the one out there. I ended up becoming like the I was like the top student. Like, they teach you how to like scratch on vinyl and all that stuff.
Ooh.
So I was out there and I was staying with friends. I was staying with some friends.
You slid in. You were one of the top.
I was top.
He just slid in.
Humble brag.
And then I ended up.
I'm a DJ.
through a crazy set of circumstances, I ended up working for the Armenian mob in a.
Jesus.
Oh, let me stop.
Hold up. Yeah.
My man, oh, well, the Armenians are deep in L.A., though.
So I got kids, cool, nigga.
Cool. No, but the Armenians are deep in L.A.
Yeah.
Hella deep in L.A.
Yeah.
Oh, is that why you came back?
Shout out to
the Kardashians.
Okay.
The Kardashians, yeah.
Shout out to the Kardashians.
They are deep in L.A.
Yeah.
Like, I forget, I was out there, and they had the...
limo companies.
Yep, yeah. All the limo companies. And then they always have their festival down, they shut down the streets.
Yeah,
like
cool.
Shut them all down.
Yeah, some of my good friends out there. So I was mm-hmm. doing that for a minute.
They always carry a blade.
So what?
Armenians.
They always carry blades?
They always have a blade
so
on.
So if you get a free limo ride, just decline.
No,
I mean, so do I. But
give you a solid limo ride. Just don't fuck with them.
Okay. Good to know.
I always carry a blade too, but that don't mean shit.
So which part of the story was that? So I was out there in Armenians. What's the original question again?
No,
you're talking about the festival.
Oh, how did I start podcasting?
Yeah,
okay,
that's kind of the nature of this podcast. So, we kind of
got you.
So bring back
after I left LA, came back out here, started working in sports radio for a while. Was doing some shows, got out of that, decided to do my own podcast.
Okay.
So I just had a lot of relationships, like friends I used to work with, people I had like connections with over the years, like, you know, different, you know, CMOs, CEOs, different entrepreneurs, business owners, people that I just have connections with. So I just did a whole podcast because actually the idea for it was I had an intern one time. And at one point I was a VP for one of the biggest PR firms in the world. And I had an intern.
Humble brag much, man?
Yo, we
one of the well, I mean, if it's facts, it's always
hustling
every day.
It's only a couple of them. So
we gonna talk.
And so I used to make sure, right? Like I would always try to make sure I looked out for, you know, everybody, right, as much as I could. So I remember one of my old interns, you know, I would like mentor him and stuff. And one day he came to me and was like, his internship was almost up, and he was like, I was like, well, you're going to apply for a job. He was like, yeah, I'm going to apply for a job. But he wanted to apply for a director role. And I was like, the fuck makes you think you can go from intern to director?
Who's going
to? Like,
these fucking millennials, man.
The job description literally says, like, you got to have, like, 10 years, multiple degrees. Like,
fuck that shit. All they do is drink coffee anyway. I could do that shit.
And I swear, he looked at me with a clear face. His answer was, because my mom said I could be whatever I wanted to be.
Oh.
And I was like, did your mom tell you to do the fucking work? And so that was actually...
So you just skipped the moment right there?
My mama said, give me that fucking job.
And that was the inspiration for my podcast.
Oh!
Everybody like thinks it's easy. You think that all these people, you know what I mean, they're like at certain points of their career, they have these titles just like happen into this stuff. But like they all got stories. They all had to bust their ass and sacrifice and do the work. And so, like, that's what I wanted to do on my podcast was, because I just had a lot of, like, relationships, people that were, like, making some really big moves and still doing. So I just wanted to, like, just showcase and just help them tell their story just so that hopefully people would listen to it and just realize, like, even though that person is, like, killing it, like, they didn't just get here overnight.
Yeah.
So that was kind of the whole, you know, the drive behind that one specifically.
Yo, that's dope because not only in general, a lot of people don't know it, especially these now what 15 to 24 year olds, they see the success, they see the movies, you know, they see the startup companies. They're like, oh, this 19-year-old started his company, blah blah blah, and they say, oh, I could do that now, like, just because I want to, because someone told me I could, which you can do, but the work behind it, you don't see all the shit that goes behind, especially, you know, now that everything is content driven, IT. You know, everything on the web, you don't see all the shit that goes behind it. Which, one thing, do you watch the show Silicon Valley?
Yeah,
of course.
That show, first of all, is hilarious.
Mm-hmm.
But that gave me a lot of insight into starting your own business. So a lot of stuff that I didn't even think about.
Yeah.
I thought about it. I was like, oh, shit. Oh, shit.
Bro, I'm telling you, man.
I didn't know you. That was a problem. That was a pitfall. That was, you know, things
like
that
a jungle sometimes.
I'm telling you, man. like I don't know if y'all ever heard of Pat Flynn before, the podcaster. So Pat Flynn runs a podcast called Smart Passive Income, right? I listen to lots of podcasts. Like his podcast, he makes, and like some of these podcasts, especially with Pat, he actually
shout out.
Posts his like monthly revenue numbers.
Oh wow.
So like on average, you know, and I mean I don't know how accurate they are, but he's pretty he's pretty straight up. But yeah. Like, you know, his on average he's posting that he's making anywhere from, you know, $100,000 to like $300,000 a month. Like running his podcast with just all the different things he's been doing. And look, I get it. You know, I see what he's done and I see him out there doing stuff. He lives in San Diego. He's killing it. But here's the thing, that's what he does. He's like, I did this 2,000 of these before I made my first dollar, right? And I just think it's easy to be like, oh, look at him, he's making all that money. It's easy. But yo, like he's done this 2,000 times and he has to do the work behind it, the editing, all that kind of stuff. Another guy, John Lee Dumas. Another big podcast is the same thing. He generates a ton of revenue. His whole claim is he does a podcast. He releases a podcast every single day, 365 days a year.
What? Different podcasts?
He interviews people, and he does them all remote. He lives in Puerto Rico or Dominican Republic with his girlfriend. Oh, like, he was like, I'm leaving the country, and this is where I live at now. You know what I'm saying?
Sure. I knew it that way.
You know, I was talking to him at Podcast Movement a couple of years ago out in L.A., and he was like, yo, man, like, the way I work is, on Tuesdays is my record day. Nobody fucking call me on Tuesday. I record my shows all from 7 a.m. till 10 p.m. I do interviews all day long.
Enough for the week.
Yeah, and that's how he does. Damn. And then he has a team. You know, he has a team where he sends them off. They do the editing and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. But that's what it takes to do 365 podcasts a year, not to mention everything. So that's why he runs a multi-million dollar business. And my whole point is, like you're saying, like, people don't see that part. Mm-hmm. And these guys even explain it and say, no, this is what it's taken. And people still like, oh, it's got to be a hack or a shortcut. No, sometimes it's just to the work and just to be in for the long term.
So I think this is episode number 68. So
almost there.
Shit, we ain't never getting there. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, we gotta get Tuesdays off.
Tuesdays happen.
Nah, man.
Two times Tuesday.
But that's dope. That podcast. Like, you used to do that. You don't do that podcast anymore, right?
But Butter and everything else, I just decided I want to focus more on like building the infrastructure for people. Mm-hmm. And so that's what that podcast. I actually built my own studio, and I was actually doing that. I actually built a studio for podcasters. They ended up selling the building, so I had to move. So that's a trick. Like, be careful. If you get a building, you know, get a space.
They had that.
They get that little building up somebody else's. You know, getting up somebody else's stuff, right? But, like, that's what I want to do is, like, now. So with Butter, it's about building the infrastructure. It's like, let's build the studio. Let's build the podcast. Let's build these things and get them ready. And then let's, like, start getting these people in this town start, like, making dope stuff consistently.
What is a podcast studio? I assume it looks nothing like this.
I mean, it's pretty close.
With beer?
Yeah. Well, no, y'all got more beer than I have in my studio. Y'all winning on that angle.
Beerologist over
I'm not mad at that at all.
It's almost a problem.
Yeah. It's almost a problem. Nigga. You see the bottles? The shelves are bending.
That's the way it's designed.
We gotta pitch in for a new shelf for this nigga, man.
It's designed that way.
Like a wood shelf or something.
I just need to drink more.
Okay.
That's what we're here for.
Yeah,
but those aren't Georgia beers, though. Well, those are just that little bit.
Man, this is
those are too.
This is the after shit. Oh, we shit. Don't.
Yeah, that's.
Well, those are all full.
Oh shit. Yeah, those are. Yeah, no, that ain't for show.
Nah. None of this. Got collector's items.
Yes,
those are on the menu.
Like beer, like baseball cards.
Yeah,
like what?
He don't fuck
we
around.
We travel. I go to different breweries, and then I just buy.
So you go to beer conventions. And I just buy beer.
Nah, this nigga's got a problem. How much money is that show? How much? Each bottle is at least 10, right?
At least. Shit. Yeah.
Oh, excuse me. Oh.
Some of them bottles are like 40.
Ace of Spades? Or
Ace of Spades got a new beer. Come check that shit out.
Nah, that's, that's a legit couple thousand dollars worth of beer, though.
God damn.
Legit. Not at one time, though. See, y'all making it sound like, nah, this was just overtime.
It's light work.
Yeah. Whatever. Man. It is. You seen some of my homies in that ATL beer game. Man, this triple, quadruple this. Shit's ridiculous.
Well.
But that's just dope, though. I mean, I like that concept of showing people the work that goes behind lots of things, you know, but especially with the, you know, the niche of, you know, content management, you know, IT, things of that nature. That's pretty dope.
What's the Butter office like? I just imagine it's like a lot of creative people and it's just fun and everybody enjoys their job
with
and the shit.
Ping pong tables and
you know they got ping pong tables. They got cornhole. Like, I'm sure they got the fucking chairs. Cornhole.
What you else? Describe in Google.
Right.
I bet you got like a King of Pops vendor right outside every day.
So we actually we King of Pops.
Oh shit.
So our office is we're technically in the first office building on the Beltline down here in Atlanta, so it's right over an old Fourth Ward.
Shout out.
We've done some stuff with King of Pops. They actually did, like, King of Pops did some butter themed pops for us last year. They didn't taste like butter, but they were yellow.
Oh, okay. It was smooth like butter. They could have done it. They're creative enough. They could have figured it out.
I saw they posted a lemon pepper pop this weekend.
They did a lemon pepper pop,
and I was a little salty about that because we've done mad lemon pepper stuff. You know what I'm saying? And like they didn't hit us up when they did it, and I'm like, come on now, we've done mad lemon pepper stuff, and we worked together on stuff. So I'm gonna come talk to y'all soon. Y'all be on the lookout.
Hey, you gotta talk.
Speaking of King of Pops, did y'all see that they're low key getting banned out of Decatur Square?
Why?
I need to read up on it, but I saw that because. Square Pub had posted something on IG about
Square it. Square Pub was like, fuck King of Pops?
Well, it wasn't them. It was an article from Decatur something.
Oh,
you know. I don't know. That's why I just saw it like earlier today or yesterday.
That's the shit, man. You either die a hero or you live long enough.
They
tried
to go to another popsicle vendor. They want another popsicle vendor in Decatur Square instead of King of Pops. I don't know what they did. I don't know what they said. It popped off.
Who's taking on King of Pops?
Right.
Pop off. It's a pop off.
Hey, I'm going to look it up.
Oh, shit. A pop off.
We can talk about it next episode.
They ain't like molest kids anything, did they?
I don't know.
I don't need another King of Pops.
Kids?
No, no.
I don't need another
down.
King of Pop.
Hey, calm down. Calm down.
Okay.
Hey. See? There you go.
Well, he said it, though.
Anyway. No, we can look it up and do it on the next episode.
Yeah. We can invite them over. They just won't come, but it's okay.
Depending on what they did.
Yeah.
Over here now.
Not in my house. Stop.
Whoa.
be easy on that one.
Okay. Cool. Well, now I think this is the end, right?
This was the postscript. That's all this was.
We appreciate you sticking around a little longer, man. Yes.
No problem.
Thank you. Anyway, talk to you guys later. Peace. Thank you guys for tuning in to the Atlanta Podcast. You can subscribe to us on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts. You can listen to us on Spotify, Stitcher, and Podbean, and wherever you get your podcasts. But if you listen to us on Apple Podcasts, be sure to leave us a review. 5 stars.
5 stars.
Always.
Anything less,
and you're an asshole.
Just don't even. Why would you?
I wouldn't go as far as an asshole, but...
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, my bad.
Less than 5 stars, and you're not for the culture.
There we go.
Boom.
Boom. Peace.